Nigga!
To get the weekend started with Friday Night Baseball from Busch Stadium in St. Louis. Tonight, the first of this three-game weekend series between the Chicago Cubs and the St. Louis Cardinals. Cardinals baseball is straight ahead, next on the show. Zach Gallen, a right-hander from the Garden State of New Jersey, gets the ball here. What do we need to know here, Danny?
Hey, how good has this guy been up to this point? In a day and age where guys and teams are scoring lots of runs, to have an ERA sub 2, that's saying something. Hopefully, we're going to see more of the same from this guy, one of the top pitchers in all.
And now here is Mario Terrell. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first.
The center fielder, Mario Terrell.
Let's go, kid. Now here's the pitch. And he gets ahead here with the fastball, strike one. Well, guys, as we look at the Cubs coming into play here tonight, they've been in a serious tailspin of late, winning just once in their previous 10 games.
Yeah, Matty, you know as well as I do, we were down there today on the field. This team is kind of in a little bit of malaise. They need to find a way to snap out of it. Tough homestand, only able to squeak out one win. This is a huge momentum game for this team.
Next to hit is Jason Hayward. Lifetime versus this arm. He's gone 5-for-13. Here now the 2-2. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Terrell is back and he'll get there to make the play for route number 2. Base is empty, two away. And up next, a Berkeley area native, Marcus Semien. Sent out to straightaway center field. And that ball gets down out near the wall and should be extra bases. Semien takes the turn at third. He wants it all. Safe at the plate as they extend their lead to two.
The fans are not happy, and I can't blame them. And inside the Parker on that hit, there's simply no excuse for that. And everyone in the ballpark knows it. We'll see if he can shake it off and get out of the top half of this inning.
Digging in next, Mario Terra, 0-for-1 for him here in this one.
Mario Terra. Come on, baby. Keep it driving. Let's go.
First pitch on its way. Strike one to start the at-bat.
The offense better get it going right here because they certainly can tell from their dugout this guy is carrying himself with a presence out on the mound. He's got feel for all his pitches.
That's in there, and he's deep in the hole now, 0-2. In the dirt. And he is in there. They couldn't get him at second. And forget about the double play now as he'll move up to second here on the wild pitch.
Well, the intent there with that two-strike pitch was obviously to get him to fish for something he couldn't do a whole lot with, but there's the risk that comes with that as well. If you don't execute or your catcher can't handle it very well, you give up free bases.
Now a fastball awfully close, but he doesn't get the call. It's 2-2 now.
I know he missed with a fastball right there, but this guy's arsenal. You can't figure out what he's trying to do. He's got a lot of different directions he could go in right here.
Throw to first will take care of him. Score it 2-3 on the putout, and there are two gone now.
Good pitch there. That was a nice job by his battery mate to complete the plate first after the ball hit the dirt.
Now back to the top of the lineup, stepping in, Mario Terrell. And we'll see what he can do here with a pair of runners on base and two gone here in the fifth. From the stretch, here's the pitch.
From an offensive standpoint, this is where you got to push the throttle right here. You've had a couple hits in the inning. You got a 1-0 count leverage. Let's see if he can gap something.
And the fastball hitting 93 on the gun. It's 1-1. Lifted in the air out to right.
Come on, dig. You're scoring.
Read on it. No problem with this one, and the inning is over. Cards strand a couple. They trail in this one 3-0. So now to the plate, David Bodie singled in his last at-bat.
Yeah, guys, everyone knows he's been slumping. Dan, you can certainly attest to this, only amassing a solid one hit in your entire career. But pressure's off now. Maybe he gets hot.
High in the air out to center field. Terrell gets under it and makes the catch to end the inning. So they breeze through this half of the inning. Not too many more shots left. Home half of the eighth coming up. The Cubs lead this one 3-0. Jonathan Holder is on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth.
Number 52, Jonathan Holder.
So here is Mario Terrell. No hits in three tries so far. He struck out once.
This is the part of the game where I think we really start seeing what teams are made of, both in terms of battling back, showing some resiliency, and in terms of knowing how to play with the lead, locking down that W.
Ball one to start the at-bat. The 1-0 delivery. Hit on the ground out to short. He's right there.
Come on, get here, get here, get here!
There's one down now.
Right to the home squad and get a win. Now the pressure's off. If they get one of the next two, the series is theirs.
And tonight's ends as a 3-0 shutout win. The Chicago Cubs jumped out to an early lead in the first and never looked back. Advert Ausele earns win number 7 on the season. Dan Winkler records the save, his 23rd of the campaign. So that's a wrap here tonight. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plezak, and Heidi Watney, this is Matt Vaskirjan. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, find us on Twitter, at MLB The Show.
No runs, 4 hits, no errors. They left 9 runners on base. Time of the ball game, 2 hours and 38 minutes. Tonight's paid attendance at Bush Stadium, a sellout, 45,529. The Cardinals would like to thank you for joining us. Please, fly home safely. Traditional gold. I'm changing grills every day, like Jay changed clothes. I might be grilled out nicely in my white tee on South Beach. In my white beef, BB a study. You can tell when they cut.
MLB The Show has baseball for you on a Saturday night in St. Louis, Missouri. Tonight, game 2 of this 3-game weekend series between the Chicago Cubs and the St. Louis Cardinals. It's baseball on The Show, and it's coming up next. Kwangyoung Kim, a Korean lefty, will be the starter in this one. What's your take on him, Dan?
Hey, you want to know if this guy's one of the better pitchers in the league? Well, how about this? Batters are hitting under 200 against this guy for the year, so he's done a good job against both righties and lefties. And I'm looking for him to be just...
And now, Mario Harold. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first.
The center fielder, Mario Harold.
Now the pitch. Hot shot and the ground is short. Reined in. And the throw to first is in time. One gone.
Four. Take your base. Three. Got it.
Next to hit, Marcus Semien. And he's a guy looking to break out in a big way. Hasn't been getting the results he or his club have been hoping for. Here's the 0-1. This is in the air out to straightaway center. Center fielder giving chase. He's there and records the first down.
That's ball four. Hey now! Ball four, take the ball.
Next, it'll be Mario Harold. 0-for-1 for him here in this one.
Mario Harold.
Hey, let it fly.
Looking to wiggle out of this. Here it is. Flying toward right center. And that will get
find the ball. Find the ball.
All right, hold on. Hold on. Right here.
Score as the Cardinals are on the board first. It's 1-0.
Dan, you know what? You like to see that from an offense. When you have a guy in a scoring position, there's no sense in waiting around. He saw a pitch he liked right there, and he went after it.
He did, D-Row, and I think that's what most hitters do. They come up with guys on base, and they can potentially drive in. They're looking for a pitch to hit, and he didn't wait around and got that bad hit started.
We're in the second with the Redbirds holding a 1-0 lead. Runner goes for second. Pitch outside. The throw is going to be far too late. That's a stolen base.
It was this, he would likely be on the move with two outs, and I'm sure the defense knew it too. But he has lightning speed and was able to take the bag anyways.
Two on, two out, and that'll bring up Jake Cronenworth.
Second base. Go.
Here's the 1-2. Here's a little chopper to the right side.
Stand up, stand up.
Throw to first in time, and the big inning is avoided as the side is retired. Cards forced to settle for one. We'll go now to the top of the third. St. Louis is out in front, 1-0.
There's a strange wind blowing. It's coming back.
Next, here is Mario Terrell. He's 1-for-2 in the ballgame. Third baseman in tight, protecting the bunt, the first pitch. Grounded down the third baseline.
Come on, come on, come on.
First will get him. Already two away here in the home fourth. Ready to go in the top of the fifth, and that'll bring forth the rookie outfielder Ross Adolph.
Still a big bagel in that hit column, and this is where the frustration can start setting in on a team if they're not careful. It's never a good feeling when you know the guy out there on the mound is completely shutting you down.
Terrell, patrolling center, makes the play, one out. Well, it's still early, but it's also worth noting that he'd be in line for the win if this keeps up as we take a look at the league leaders in games won this season. And as you see, he's up near the top, currently tied for second in that category in the National League. Last time up.
Yeah, I understand that, Matty, but this guy's got burner wheels down the first baseline. I don't think he even concerns himself with that. He has to put it on the ground. That's part of what makes him successful.
And a fastball misses here to start the at bat. It's 1-0. And now a pitch on the way.
Ball two. Two balls, no strike.
Come on, big guy, one time. Here you go.
Two balls and a strike to the St. Louis leadoff hitter. Two and two. This is hit high in the air out toward left center. Howe will slide over and put this one away, and that's out number one. New inning set to get underway, and up next, Nico Horner.
The second baseman, Nico Horner.
Lifted into center field. Terrell is right there, one down. Next to dig in, Mario Terrell flew out last time up.
Mario Terrell.
Comes set. Here's the nothing and nothing pitch.
You know, because this is just a one-run game, this doesn't strike me as a situation where he's going to be working around a guy. I think he's going to challenge him right here.
Weak grounder down the line at third, but a foul ball, 1-1.
Hey, your pitch, no one better.
Slider finds the zone for a strike.
1-2.
Here's a little chopper up the middle. He's got to hurry, and he'll just step on second for the force, and that'll do it for this half inning. One left for the Cardinals. They lead it 2-1. Save his 13th of the year. So that'll do it for us. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plezak, Heidi Watney, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way over to the new website, theshow.com.
Time of the ball game, 2 hours and 37 minutes. Tonight's paid attendance at Busch Stadium, a sellout, 45,529. The Cardinals would like to thank you for joining us. Please drive home safely.
Baseball now on a lazy Sunday afternoon at Busch Stadium in St. Louis. Today, the finale of this three-game weekend series between the Chicago Cubs and the St. Louis Cardinals. It's Cardinals baseball next on the show.
The road that I've been traveling on is secluded and astray.
Miles Michaelis, a right-hander from Florida, gets the ball as the starter here. What do we need to know here, Danny?
Hey, in this day and age where we're used to seeing a lot of home runs and pitchers not going very deep in a game, how about this guy? ERA in the low ones. That's not an easy thing to do. He can strike people out.
Stepping up is Mario Terrell. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first.
The center fielder, Mario Terrell.
The pitch. Fastball here as he'll take a look at ball one. 1-0. Dan, D-Row, the Cubs as they take the field here this afternoon. It was another loss for them last time out, and that makes them 2-8 over their last 10 games.
Yeah, Maddie, this is the big one right here. They've split the first two games of this series. You want to steal one right here and be feeling good about yourself.
Yeah, D-Row, I think one of the things you want to do, you get to the third game, you'd like to win this series and finish it off by winning game three. It's always nice to win a series, whether it's at home or on the road. So this is a big one.
Flew out in his last AB. Here's the first pitch to him. Hit back up the middle. He's got it. And the off-balance throw gets him as he takes away a hit and the side is retired. So they go down without a whimper here. On now to the top of inning number four. All tied at 1-1.
Take the base.
Next up, Mario Terrell. It's been an 0-for-2 effort for him to this point.
Terrell.
First pitch on the way.
Ball. 1-0.
Hey, come on, big dog. Get your pick.
The 1-0. Heading out towards shallow right. Hayward is there, and he'll put it away to retire the side. So no runs on a hit here, no errors, one man left on. Five innings complete. It's the Cubs 2 and the Cardinals 1. Here's Matt Adams now. A hit and two tries for him so far.
Matt Adams.
High in the air out to center field.
Two.
Terrell will settle under it to make the play for the first out as the runner will have to head back to first. The next Cub up, Richard Alfonso, 0-for-2 on the afternoon so far. Hit high and deep to right center. Long run for the center fielder. He tracks it down and makes the play to record the second out. St. Louis, Mario Terrell flew out last time up. Third baseman in tight protecting the bunt, the first pitch. And it's fouled away. Ball and a strike.
1-1.
Slow little grounder, left side. Dick. Throw in time at first for out number 2.
3.
Now it'll be David Bode. He grounded out last time up. The 2-2. Lifted in the air to center.
Yeah, you got it.
Terrell is there now, and he has it. Two gone.
Three.
Hey, listen, in baseball, we don't see very many complete games any longer because of pitch counts, but listen, he was good from the first inning through the ninth. Well-deserved complete game victory.
6-1, the final tally today. Chicago took the lead in the fourth and held on until the end. Cristobal Caballero takes the win on the mound, his second of the year. And it's a dandy, a complete game, three-hit performance. So that will wrap things up. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our whole crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, head to theshow.com.
For St. Louis, one run on 3 hits, no errors. They left 5 men on base. Time of the ball game, 3 hours exactly.
Nothing lasts forever, but this is gonna take me down. He's so tall and handsome as hell. He's so bad, but he does it so well. I can see the end as it begins. My one condition is say you'll remember me. Standing in a nice dress, staring at the sunset, babe. Red lips and rosy cheeks. Say you'll see me again, even if it's just in your dreams. said, no one has to know what we do.